The difference between sex and gender is that sex is a biological concept based on biological characteristics, such as the difference in genitalia in male and female. Gender, on the other hand, primarily deals with personal, societal, and cultural perceptions of sexuality. The concept of gender and sex has been a hot-button issue in recent years, particularly with the modern wave of progressive thought, where these concepts are becoming more flexible. Human beings are no longer bound by binary concepts such as male-female, masculine-feminine, or man-woman. So, for those who want to progress with the times and embrace the full spectrum of human identity, a common question arises. What is the difference between sex and gender? The term sex refers to biological characteristics, namely chromosomes, internal and external sex organs, and the hormonal activities within the body. The scientific designation of sex is therefore based on genetics and is difficult to change. The variation in sex chromosomes, XY for men, XX for women, determines a person's sex, as well as the hormonal variations in their body. For example, females have much higher levels of estrogen and progesterone, while males have higher levels of testosterone. These hormonal differences result in physiological variations between the sexes, such as body hair, voice pitch, and muscle size, among others. However, there is not a clear binary between men and women. Some women have a Y chromosome, while some men have two or even three X chromosomes. Intersex humans have sexual characteristics of both men and women, and this includes a number of more specific conditions, including hermaphroditism. As you can see, sex is not as clear-cut as we once thought, but the real spectrum appears when we talk about gender. Gender is not based in science, but is rather based on societal constructs and belief systems regarding masculinity and femininity. These constructs relate to color choices, such as blue for boys and pink for girls, as well as our hair length, the clothes we wear, the partners we choose, and the interests that are deemed appropriate. Despite these seemingly strict boundaries, males and females are very much alike. Every major bodily system functions in similar ways, and we require the same things for survival. However, the social construct of gender builds on the separation of biological sex by focusing on how we are different, rather than alike. Historically, gender roles have been extremely powerful in shaping society, and even today, fluid gender roles meet a great deal of opposition. Outdated ideas of female subservience, inequality between the sexes, and the illegality of fluid sexuality still exist in many parts of the world. However, throughout history, we can also find many gender identification markers that have changed or entirely reversed, including high heels, makeup, wigs, and the color pink, all of which were once associated with power and masculinity, but have switched to a more female association in the past two centuries. This reinforces the idea that gender is and has always been fluid. Gender fluidity does away with the cult of masculinity or the traditions of subservience that have defined gender for so long and oppressed people's true nature for millennia. Although many people still believe that sex is determined by nature, while gender is determined by nurture, that modern take is still an outdated binary. Sex may impact gender, but neither of these concepts functions as a complete definition. These terms can describe an individual, but they cannot and should not define them.